Hey guys, thanks for clicking on this video. Today I'm showing you how I cut Nick's hair. Some of you guys have been wondering. Anyways, I've been cutting Nick's hair for like two or three years now. It's a lot of fun, and so I'll give you any of the tips that I have, but everything has been basically handed down from my friend Heather, so she taught me just the regular techniques that I still use, so. I hope you enjoy this video, and let's get into it. Time to give him a haircut. We use the Remington, I'm not sure exactly which, oh, model HC5850.
I'm sure it has a name.
It is, it's model HC5850. The whole kit comes with this, and then it comes in this case and stuff with all of the different sizes, and it comes with scissors. I don't know,
Yeah, I think that comb came with it.
I'm not sure if the comb came with it, but obviously combs are like $2 each. So no. I learned my techniques from my friend Heather. So shout out to Heather. She always cut my hair, and she always cuts her husband's hair and other people's hair.
Kids.
So I got like basically everything I know is from her, and then I've just been practicing. I pretty much cut your hair once a month. Some cuts are great, some cuts are not so great. So let's hope that this is a good cut today. 1/8 inch on the sides if he wants it like shorter. And it's the summer, so shorter is better and it lasts longer. Let's get going.
All right, that's fun.
I'm gonna start with the back. I normally start with the back anyways. I don't know what I'm doing, start with the side. Hair is really long right now, so normally it's been more than a month I think since I cut his hair last, which will be a lot more fun for the before and afters. Then once I get kind of to the top, he's got this weird like cowlick here, so what I've kind of figured works right here is to cut it shorter on the bottom of the cowlick. So right here, obviously, I haven't buzzed anything. But what I like to do is I kind of like see the line of the back of his head, and I'll try and like pull that forward like this. And then I'll take the razors and just go like straight up. I don't like follow the curve of his head. I just go like straight up. You don't follow the curve of their head, it blends this way nicer into the longer parts. So as you can kind of see, it is a little bit longer here, but once you start cutting it, it really looks like it's more blended. Whereas I think I've done before where I just like literally follow his natural shape, it just looks like it cuts straight off. So it's not very blended at all. I do the same for the side. Where I'll kind of like pull his hair kind of where I want it to blend, and I'll hold it like off to the side when I'm buzzing. So then I'm doing the same technique where I'm just gonna go straight and straight up.
As a kid, I never could sit still going to
He still can't. Just so you know, don't
I
don't
feel like I've been pretty good.
Don't let him fool you. I'm constantly like, can you stop moving? Sir, hold your head up. All right, so then for the top, I normally grab a spray bottle. Let's see if this one works today. And I'll take my comb and I'll comb it through. Cute. Styling. He looks like Mo, I always say that. Then I use my scissors. It depends on how short you actually want to make the top. Hopefully you'll be able to see this, but I pull it up with the comb until there's just like a little bit of hair over the comb, and then I'll snip that off. I do it a little bit shorter in the back. You can kind of like angle your brush, and so it's gonna be longer where obviously the brush is higher, shorter where the brush is going down. So if you angle it like that in the back, then the parts toward the very back are gonna be a little bit shorter than the parts like right here. The front, I'm not really sure what I do to the front. I just kind of wing it.
People were saying that there was a earthquake.
Yeah.
Last night at like 3 a.m. or something.
Ashley texted, she was like, did you guys feel the earthquake?
Like,
I was like, what earthquake?
Like, slept like rocks.
So once I finish the cut on the top, I go through and just kind of one more time blend the sides. The last thing is trimming around his ears. So I just need to trim around here because there's stuff that the razor can't reach. And then I need to trim his neck. And for that, I just take off all of the guards and just go straight down to the natural blade. It's okay if you cut his ear. I do it every time. The best part of our deal with me cutting his hair is that I cut his hair and he does the cleanup. How do you feel about cleaning up?
Good, I got a free haircut and it's awesome.
So yeah, now it's really, oh, there's a plane, hold on. So that's it. That's all we've got for you today. I hope you learned something and maybe you can now cut your husband's hair or your brother's hair or whoever it is, because it really does save a lot of money. And that was one of the reasons why I ended up learning how to cut hair in the first place, was to save money. We've saved a lot of money and it's fun, and the more you do it, the better you get at it. So practice makes perfect, and I'm not even anywhere close to being perfect, but I just wanted to show you what I normally do because I know some people have been surprised that I do cut his hair. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Give it a thumbs up if you found it helpful, and I'll see you in the next video.